Hi again. So finally we are rendering our project. In the last series, we went over how to perform a disk render. To recap, in the render node parameters, make sure your path is set correctly. If it's not, you can edit this in the DR settings parameters. Right-click on the render node and select disk render. And once your render has finished, it'll display on the monitor, as well as write out the rendered image on the set location. For rendering multiple frames at once, you can use the batch mode, and the process is different. It will only run on a render license. If you've not used Cortana before, you might not be used to this way of working, but in fact there's so much to gain from this workflow. First of all, you don't have to pre-process anything, hence removing the need of RIB, VR scenes, or ASS files. This saves a huge amount of space that is otherwise used up really quickly. The deferred loading feature is preserved, and you don't necessarily need to remove unused assets, since they're not processed anyway. As a result, this can be very time and cost effective. So the first thing we'll do is look back at the Foundry documentation and type in batch render. This gives you instructions on how to send a batch render via command line, and this is what we'll do. You'll see an example string. You can simplify the string by setting the viewer flag to the required render node in Cortana. So you won't need to specify it in the string. You need to make sure your Cortana scene has been saved. You can even run this with Cortana open, so don't worry about closing it if you still want to access your scene. Open a terminal or command prompt, depending on whether you're using Windows or Linux. In this case, I'm using Windows. Navigate to where your Cortana executable is located. If you're on Windows, it'll be in the Program Files folder. In Linux, it'll be the user local directory. Once you're in the correct directory, we can run this command. We've broken up this expression to show how the string is laid out, where you launch Cortana, send in batch mode, identify where your Cortana project is, and set the frame range. In this case, this is what I have. This will queue a render. If you want to specify your graph state variables, you can see on the documentation where you can access this information. This makes it very easy to send a render while avoiding confusion as to what you're rendering out. Once you have multiple shots with many variables, this feature becomes crucial. If you're using a farm, there are existing submission tools that have an integration with Cortana. Otherwise, the farm API in Cortana allows you to plug in whatever solution you might need. This wraps up the series. We've covered how to create a multi-shot scene. A recurring theme was organization and efficiency. You have access to this scene, so please don't hesitate to play around with it and share your findings. I hope you've enjoyed this series. We welcome feedback, requests, and other information you'd like to pass on.